Here are some materials I took outside to test to see which plastics are recyclable and which ones are not. The top row are the 8 different types of objects I'll be trying to melt. The bottom row is some of the testing and safety equipment I'll be using. I'll be wearing the respirator on the right to prevent breathing any toxic fumes produced by the plastics that don't melt when heated, but instead undergo a chemical reaction and produce new substances when heated. I'm wearing oven gloves to protect my hands as I use a high temperature heat gun to blow hot air onto each plastic. Here we can see that the surface temperature of the plastic has reached 176 degrees Fahrenheit. Any video will be sped up and the background audio dropped out. Here I place a nickel on the melted plastic and push into it to see if I can get it to form to the shape of the nickel. That was successful, so now I'm going to try to pull on the plastic and reshape it using pliers. That also was successful. The plastic didn't give any evidence of undergoing a chemical reaction when heated, so I'm assuming this is a thermoplastic, something that is recyclable. Let's heat this second object to see if it's a thermoplastic as well. It is starting to flow like a liquid as I heat it, and I am able to reform it into a new shape. This also seems to be another thermoplastic. All right, let's try a third object, this styrofoam cup. This is interesting because this one seems to be breaking apart. The little white beads that make it up are separating as I heat it. Can't tell if that's melting or not. I can't reshape it very easily either, which maybe is because it cooled down and now is a solid again. I'm not sure if this is a thermoplastic or not. This fourth object melts clearly upon heating and doesn't undergo a color change and reforms into a new shape. So I'm assuming this one is a thermoplastic. Something different happened to this object as I heated it. I noticed a browning on the surface, similar to what you see when you bake something in the oven. I think this color change is evidence of a chemical reaction rather than a phase change, which tells me this plastic is probably a thermoset rather than a thermoplastic. The underlying material has softened some, so I can reform it, but I'm not convinced that it's only gone through a phase change here. This piece of insulating foam also undergoes a color change, but this one blackens, similar to burning and cooking. And I can't get this one to form into a new shape. Pretty sure this is a thermoset. This water pipe is made of a material called PVC. I'm heating it and seeing a color change on it as well, a browning. So new substances are getting produced. This is why I'm wearing my respirator, because it's reported that many of these substances are toxic to breathe. The underlying plastic is still warm and I can reform it, but again, the color change to me seems to indicate that this is a thermoset rather than a thermoplastic. It was less clear to me whether this last object was made of a plastic that's recyclable. While it did reform into a new shape, it was hard to tell whether it was a color change, maybe because it was tan to begin with. It was difficult to determine if it had browned or blackened.